Hey, what's up nerds? Keon here with a quick video to show you how to use the new track mat transition feature inside of OBS version 27 for live streaming. If you're not familiar with what track mats are, a mat is essentially a black and white video that tells software what's visible and what is transparent. For now, this is only possible in OBS Studio and XSplit, but I'm sure this feature will roll out to other software soon enough. Now, before we get started, here's my usual reminder to hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you're always kept up to date on new product launches, tools, and tips and tricks from us here at Nerd or Die. In tandem with this video, we are also releasing a free matte transition pack on our website with 5 free dynamic transitions and a premium matte transition pack that contains 20 transitions, all of which work great with live streaming and video editing projects. Head on over to nerdordie.com or click the link in the description for more info. And back to the video. Inside of OBS, there are now 3 types of transitions. The first one is one we've all grown to know and love, the classic stinger. An animation covers up the screen for at least 1 frame, the scene change happens behind that, and then the animation just goes away. The second one is the new track mat transition, a straight transition from one scene to another. And the third, which is probably the coolest, uses a bit of both. Now, although there are some awesome stinger transitions out there, we all already know about these. So I'm gonna focus on and show you how to correctly set up each of the new matte transition types. For this tutorial, we're going to be using the matte transition pack we discussed earlier. Link is still in the description, just waiting for you. You know you want to click it, so just do it already. Now, let's assume you're adding a matte stinger to an existing setup. For the sake of this mini guide, let's remove any current stinger transitions we have set up. Click the cog, then click remove. First, let's do a basic scene-to-scene matte transition. Select add stinger from the dropdown here and a little box will pop up. This is where you can name whatever you're creating. We're gonna click OK, and let's move down and check Use a Track Mat, otherwise this won't work. Next, we wanna choose a video file. Hit Browse, find your mat transition, and select Open. And let's give it a test. Really cool, right? Am I the only one that thinks this is awesome? We're 27 versions into OBS, and I'm so happy that we can finally do transitions like this. For demonstration purposes, let's try out another one and see what happens. I wasn't kidding when I said I was really excited for these transitions. They're just so clean and professional looking to me. Okay, on to the best use of matte transitions, where the creative and the technical world collide. Going forward, we here at Nerd or Die will be creating more and more stingers that take advantage of what I'm about to show you. So let's hit defaults in the bottom left corner to reset everything. Now let's browse once more. I've got a stinger in here that's from our Electro Junkie 2 package. You'll notice that all of these transitions are extra wide, and there's a good reason for that, which I'll explain in a second. So let's import it. If I run a test of this right now, it's going to look very wrong. What we see here is 2 graphics side by side. On the left, we have the visual representation of the stinger, and on the right, we have the mat. Now let's select Use a Track Mat. For this specific file I have, we want to use the first option here. Same file, side by side, because if you remember, our file is the stinger on the left and the mat on the right. Now if we preview the transition, you get to see the full power of matte transitions. Not to make a Palpatine joke, but this really is
unlimited power
when it comes to stinger transitions. And that's it for this tutorial. It can be a little confusing at first, but I hope this video has cleared up what a matte stinger transition is, and I can't wait to see more of them out in the wild. If you're a creative yourself, or you want to be surrounded by other creatives that will without a doubt be using this new feature, we have a Discord you can jump on in. Don't be afraid to show off your creations either. We love getting to see the Nerd or Die community's work. We also have a dedicated help section in there, so if you do download our matte transitions, which you totally should do, free is free, hit us up there with any questions, comments, or concerns. Once again, those free transitions and the premium ones will be linked down below, or you can find them on our website at nerdordie.com. I've been Keon with Nerd or Die, and I'll see you guys in the next one.